we are loaded. Local time here is 3:11, so I've only been sitting here for 11 minutes. Let me go get the bills, seals, and I'll be right back. Peace.
Hey everybody, Johnny Be Good here. Alright, we are loaded and we got our bills, so it's time to go. Local time here is 3:48. My immediate goal right now is to go to the TA truck stop in Russell Road. Oh, Russell, Illinois. two fly. Well, we gotta go that way. Yeah, a fly went out. Imagine that. One of the things that I like about this Volvo is the side posts are smaller than the Freightliner. I've noticed that the Freightliner, small cars and vehicles will actually hide on that post, which is kind of scary sometimes. All right, seatbelt. Yep, it turns out Volvo has this seatbelt warning if you don't wear your seatbelt. Extremely low on fuel. You know, as I've been driving this truck for a couple of days now, I still think that Baby Blue was riding the Freightliner. Cascadia rides a lot better than this Volvo. I don't even know what model this Volvo is, but the only thing that I really like about this truck so far is the oversized windows, oversized windshield, and the oversized mirrors. So we're gonna take this 11 East. If you're not on the shifter right away, you lose it. So once again, today it is Wednesday, right? September 12th, 2018. Local time is 3:54 Central. And we'll catch you guys later. Peace. Hey, welcome to Union Grove. Wisconsin. Local time is 4:21. Sort of a 7 miles. They're harvesting the corn already. I've seen corn around Wisconsin having harvest since like early, I don't know, November. It practically, sometimes it snows before they harvest. They look pretty darn small, though. I don't know, maybe they altered the genetic of these corns where they don't have to grow so high to produce the corn anymore. GMO. merging on to 41 South and 94 East. I can't tell you how nerve-wracking this low fuel gauge that I've got right now. It's just one of those things you pray and hope for the best. One of the things that threw me off was, like in my car, it's got that gauge where it tells you how many gallons you have in your tank, and it tells you how many miles you got until empty. And when I was a quarter of a tank full of fuel, I think it said like 36 or 46 gallons, and then 400 miles to empty. Like, what? There ain't no way you're gonna make 400 miles in 40 gallons. But basically, it really comes down to I was running late, and I didn't know that this place was open around the clock. Otherwise, I would have gotten fuel. Well, we're almost at the TA. You know, if I had some time, or if I had some fuel right now, I would have stopped at that cheese place again. But I gotta take care of this low fuel issue. I think I'm delivering to U.S. Food Service in Manassas, Virginia. Oh, there's a fuel stop right there. I could have stopped over there at the BP. Bobby Nelson right there. I could have picked up some good cheese. Scary low on fuel. There was one time where I was running low on fuel, and I literally just, when I pulled into the fuel island, she started sucking air, so I just coasted to the fuel island, and before she started, when she started sucking fuel, I turned it off right away. Well, I think I first goosed it, put it on neutral, goosed it, and shut it off. I goosed it just to put fuel in the line, and I coasted it right in the fuel island, and it was dead. That was as low you can get without running empty. Oh, I don't know how many times I've run out of fuel over, you know, the years of trucking I did. Too many times. Let's grab the right lane. So I believe this is Kenosha, Wisconsin. Local time is 4:27. And I don't feel like going through Illinois right now. So I might just hang around at the TA for a couple hours. I don't want to be in rush hour traffic. All right, we are exit, at the exit 345. The last exit for Wisconsin is 349. So 4 more miles to the exit, 5 miles to the TA. Whew. So basically, I just need 1 gallon of fuel. Lord, just 1 gallon. Just need 1 gallon to make it to the TA, right? By the way, I got a confession to make. I do not know how to open the hood on this thing. I have looked for levers and latches and I don't know. So when I pull into the fuel island here, I'm gonna have to wait for a Volvo driver and ask them how to open the hood. How embarrassing, right? JVG Travels, a professional steering wheel holder. Bow. Probably just gonna get about 50 gallons of fuel here. Welcome to Illinois, everybody. Looks like the Wisconsin way station could be open. Russell Road. City. What do you think? We made it. You know, when I started today, I was so, so discouraged and so, like, I don't know, so mad at myself because I could have avoided all this drama and to myself, you know. And it's kind of like, as I mentioned, it's one mistake after another. And, oh boy. Alright, I'm looking for a Volvo driver. So that we could ask how much or how to open the hood. All right, we'll catch you guys later. Peace.